So many of my students come to me with the same two challenges when applying to data jobs. Either they sent out tons of resumes and heard very few interview callbacks, or they started doing certifications, they've done online tutorials, built portfolio projects, maybe even they work with data on their current job, but they're not sure what the right next step is, and they're not sure when they're ready to start applying. Now, on average, before students apply a strategic path, they apply to over 150 jobs and hear back from less than 5 companies. That's basically a part-time job in itself. But after they start applying the right steps, students who get jobs do so within an average of 80 resumes, and suddenly they're getting resume to interview conversion rates of 8%, 20%, sometimes even 90%. Imagine sending out 15 resumes and hearing back from 13 of those companies, like my student Tyreek. So how are they actually pulling this off? Today, I want to talk to you guys about the 4 strategic paths that I've seen work for my students, no matter what background you're coming from. If you're new here, I'm Christine. I'm a former data director and a hiring manager who now helps people take the most strategic path to working a job in data. If that sounds helpful to you, make sure to subscribe and let's dive in. If your resume to interview conversion rate is less than 5% and you've applied to over 100 jobs, then something is not working. Either the jobs aren't the right fit, your resume isn't telling the right story, or both. Just remember that hiring managers are not actually looking for someone who just has technical tools. They want to see that you've actually applied those tools to the day-to-day business questions that we actually get on the job. But the thing is, most resumes don't actually show that. 3 big gaps usually cause this problem: the business application, industry relevance, and job title relevance. So that's things like, did you actually use SQL, Excel, or dashboards to solve a business problem, or did you just finish a portfolio project? Have you touched data that looks like the company data, healthcare claims, retail sales, HR metrics, or whatever it is? And also, do your past roles and the names of those roles actually hint or show that you've worked in a setting that overlaps with analytics? Remember that it shouldn't take 500 applications to land a job. It just takes 1 clear story that matches the right company. The problem is that most people try to take 1 big jump from being an aspiring analyst to getting hired, not realizing that there's actually a bridge of experience that you need to build in between. That's things like having applied technical skills, business communication, as well as domain knowledge. Now, if you're watching this video, you're probably in one of these 4 different buckets. Either you have some corporate experience, but you're not really working that closely to data. Maybe you're a recent grad, or you just don't have corporate experience, or maybe you took some time off recently. Maybe you're an analyst who actually does have analytical data experience in the last 2 years, but you're still not getting callbacks. Or maybe you actually work on a team that actually is really close to the data team right now. Now, each of these different circumstances has a strategic path that can shortcut you from cold applying to building the right bridge of experience and immediately standing out. So let's say you already have some corporate experience, but you're not really working that closely to data and you want to move into full-time data analyst work. What you actually need is a hybrid role. These are jobs where 30 to 40% of your time is analysis and the rest is related to your domain knowledge. So any job that has analyst, insights, reporting, data, or technical in the title is potentially a hybrid role. For example, operations analyst, marketing analyst, or insights and reporting manager. Try mixing a domain keyword from your field plus the word analyst and see what comes up. The idea here is that you first spend some time in a domain role. So maybe your current job has little to no data analysis. The next jump that you take is actually to a hybrid role, which mixes analysis and your domain knowledge and uses your experience as leverage to jump to that more technical position. And then after about a year in that hybrid role, you stand a much better chance of standing out for those pure data roles. So let me give you an example of how some of my students have done this. One of my students, Dennis, just landed a job as a content strategy and analysis analyst at Pandora. He used his domain knowledge working in the content creation industry and leveraged that to land a more analytical role. You can see that these hybrid roles are actually data analyst roles in disguise, just wrapped around specific domain knowledge. So for example, it mentions data analytics, it says experience with database languages and data visualization tools, as well as experience with Microsoft Office and comparable Google products and PowerPoint. Another student was an e-commerce office lead at Hyundai in Korea for a few years before she was trying to make the transition into working in data. She landed her first job in the US as a technical account manager at a company called Backmarket. Now, Backmarket is also an e-commerce company, so she leveraged her e-commerce background to make the jump. You can see that this role prioritizes the domain knowledge of experience in account management, but then it also says SQL and or Tableau experience is a plus, readiness to learn and hone analytic skills is a must. And because she already had some data analytic skills, she really stood out for this job. Now, usually it will stand out if you spend at least 2 years in that domain role and are in the hybrid position for at least a year before you start transitioning to that pure data analyst position. Obviously, it can go longer or shorter depending on your situation. But the important thing to remember here is that sometimes the fastest way into data is sideways. You don't have to get hung up on specific job titles. Just look for the kinds of positions where you can naturally wedge more data analytics into what you're already doing. Okay, so what if you don't have that much corporate experience at all? I'm looking at all my recent grads out there and anyone who has taken a career break or worked in a completely different industry. In that case, you need to build proof before you build a paycheck through some kind of low barrier work that might be paid or unpaid. And I get it, no one really wants to do unpaid work, but honestly, sending out 500 applications is unpaid work as well. So at least this way, you come out of it with something to show. One or two strong experiences where you solved real problems with data can completely change the way that your resume reads. So you have a number of different options here, and I've ordered them from those that are low barrier, but also lower pay. Volunteering experiences, you can usually find something within a few weeks, to something that is higher barrier and higher pay. Freelancing tends to be a lot more competitive, but at the same time, they will typically actually pay you. For volunteering, many nonprofits can use help with their spreadsheets or dashboards, and it's a really good chance to practice Excel, SQL, or Tableau in the real world. You can check out organizations like Catchafire, Volunteer Match, or Idealist. And you can also approach schools or hospitals or other organizations in your local community to do free volunteer work. But you do want to be a little bit careful here because sometimes the scope can be really fuzzy and sometimes stakeholders can be a bit less responsive. For fellowships, now something like the Blue Bonnet Fellowship is an amazing opportunity to actually hone your data skills while actually getting mentorship from other people in the industry. Especially if you're working in something that's really not a corporate job. For example, I had a student, Stephanie, who was working as a music therapist. She did the Blue Bonnet Data Fellowship and then landed a job as a sales and marketing analyst at Balanced Body. Then there's internships, and this is obviously the best option for recent grads, but they are quite competitive. You can check out platforms like Handshake, which is actually a platform that matches people based on the university that they're in to internship opportunities. I haven't personally used this myself, but I've heard good things about it, and it's geared towards Gen Z and recent grads. Of course, you can also use LinkedIn to search for internships. Then there's freelancing, and this is where you actually pitch your skills to small businesses. And you can obviously check out platforms like Upwork or Fiverr. To be honest, I don't really recommend that because I think the competition there is quite high, and I don't really think the kind of data work that's posted there is the best. Instead, I recommend pitching yourself to small businesses in your local community or within your secondary network. If you think about it, anyone who owns an Etsy shop or does content creation probably has data and could also probably use some help tracking their North Star KPIs and building some rudimentary dashboards. In all of these opportunities, there's three main things to prioritize: using the technical tools, so SQL, Excel, Tableau, a visualization software, working with real stakeholders. These stakeholders do not have to be super high up at a company. Anyone who uses your report or your process is a stakeholder. And working with real business data. Ideally, it would be in an industry that you're actually interested in working in long term. And honestly, what would you rather say in an interview? That you applied to 300 jobs and you got ghosted, or you did some work for a nonprofit organization and you built their first fundraising dashboard? Now, one of those is actually a conversation starter. So path three is for people who already have some analytics experience, but they're not landing interviews. Now, let's say you already satisfy about 70% of the requirements of the jobs that you're applying to, and you have a standout resume, but you're still not hearing back. Then you don't need more projects, you need more visibility. Now, I know networking makes people cringe, and to be honest, I cringe too when I see a lot of messages like this. But the truth is that 80% of networking messages are bad. They're generic, they're copy-paste, and they're basically spam, which means that you only need to be not bad, because the right networking approach can get you interviews within days. For some students, I've seen this happen even within a matter of hours. Now, there's three main factors that you need to have down to be able to do networking right. First is to have a standout resume and cover letter, then to draft a value-driven message that you're going to send to decision makers like hiring managers and recruiters, and to lean your LinkedIn towards all your data experiences to have a data-oriented profile. For the first one, you want to make sure that you slightly tailor your resume to match keywords from the job description. You want to have a concise, personal cover letter tying your skills to the company's specific mission or values. For a value-driven networking message, you want to frame it as, here are three specific and unique reasons why I think I'd be a great fit for this role. You're not going to send out some generic message with your resume just asking for a referral. You're going to make it obvious to them how you bring value to their team. And then lastly, you're going to lean all your previous roles towards data and show business-oriented data projects and skills on your profile so that that hiring manager or recruiter can immediately see what you're about. For example, one of my students said just yesterday that a recruiter had reached out to him a couple days ago on LinkedIn for a machine learning consultant role. And it had been a while since he was contacted by a recruiter. But in just the last week, he had gotten three in-mails just because he had made some small changes to job titles and his experience to align more to those data analyst positions. It just goes to show you how those small changes can make a really big difference. And here's an example of a winning networking message that one of my students sent for a job that he ultimately landed. So he said, while it appears the job opening is now closed on your company page, I thought it was wise to send along my credentials. As someone with experience creating original content for a healthcare company who is well-versed in analytics tools like Excel, Tableau, and SQL, this position presents a great opportunity to combine my past experiences to drive success. So I want you to reframe this for yourself. Networking is not begging. It's showing the right people that you are the solution to their problem. Now, one of the best kept secrets is that sometimes the easiest way to land a data job is to not apply at all. If you already work somewhere that has a data team, then pivoting internally can be one of the best ways to transition to data work without needing to go through the job hunt. I know a lot of people who come from backgrounds in marketing, sales, HR, finance, supply chain, accounting, or engineering, and for them, they work very closely with the data team already. You might not already be a data analyst, but you might work very closely to the data team, and you should use that to your advantage. So here is the playbook. First, you want to start small. Just think to yourself, what are small technical tasks in your work that you can start to take on? Is it running a SQL query? Is it doing some of the data cleaning yourself? Is it actually looking at the dashboard and downloading the data and starting to understand how that dashboard is powered? If you have an opportunity to make this more part of your day-to-day job, that's when you can also bring the conversation up to your manager. And you want to frame the value as how it can actually be helpful to your current role. So something like, hey, I think learning a bit of SQL would help our reporting run faster. And you want to frame it as something that can help your day-to-day, not as a reason why you want to move away from your current role. The third is to start building trust. So learn from the data team and offer to collaborate. I'll tell you right now that every data analyst dream stakeholder would be someone who would say, hey, can I spend a little bit of time with you next week just reviewing some SQL code? Because I want to make sure that I can run some of the code myself so that I don't always depend on you to run the updated queries. Think about if you can start setting up some sessions here and there with the data analyst to learn from them and see how they use their tools on the job. And then the fourth is to actually apply or pivot if the opportunity is there. So after you have more of a relationship with the data team, you can see if there's a role that's open or open the conversation for a formal pivot or transition. Now, this is exactly what my student Bernie did, who's working on the talent team. And he spoke with the director about evolving his role into something more multifunctional. The director actually highlighted a major need for improvement in their team's analytics, especially in updating interactive dashboards. And so starting this year, Bernie's actually going to be taking full ownership of analytics within the HR department. That is an amazing way to take a role that seems like it's not that data relevant into something that is basically a data analyst position. So consider whether the shortest bridge to starting a career in data might actually be the one that you're already standing on. Okay, so let's wrap this up. Today we covered the four strategic paths to break into data. You could sneak in sideways, build your proof, get visible, or start leveraging where you already are. So if you want to save yourself months of time and energy in this transition into working your first job in data, then you might be interested in my mentorship program. I'm opening up applications for the next cohort below, and I would love to see your name come through. And if there's anything you take from this video, just remember, don't apply to tons of jobs. Pick the right jobs, build your bridge of experience so that you can actually stand out and confidently apply yourself to the job hunt and the actual job. That's it for this video. I'll see you guys in the next one.